Yo, what's good, everybody? It's your boy Boone coming at you guys with a brand new video. Today we got the Supreme Week 16 drop list to talk to you guys about. I'm super excited about this week. Not really though, it's honestly not that dope of a week. However, Supreme North Face is trying its best to put this week on its back and carry it to victory. I made a video yesterday talking about the Supreme North Face drop, so go check that out if you want to see me in depth talk about all these items, because I don't think I'm going to cover them too much in this video. I will briefly give my opinion on them. I have seen a lot of people hating on this collab, the TNF collab, so let me know if you guys like it or not. I honestly think it's gonna look way better in person than it does in all these previews. I do think once you guys see all these items in person, you guys will like them a lot more. However, I do understand they could have done a way better job with the snakeskin print. I've seen so many mock-ups that look 10 times better than the actual snakeskin design that they're releasing. Also, there should be more colorways, but let's get into today's video. Before I do get into it, I want to show off to you guys two packages I got in the mail today. I'm always ordering stuff from my website and my Instagram at Seattle Select. I'm currently selling a ton of Supreme stuff on my story. Go check that out if you want to buy anything out of my Supreme collection. I have so much Supreme. Like, I'm sure a lot of you guys can realize that, as my whole channel is based around Supreme. I got all this Supreme garbage right next to me right here. But yeah, let's jump in and look at these items I have to unbox for you guys, and we'll go into the video in a second. I hope you all enjoy. So the first item I have to show to you guys is these Champion sweatpants. Little cuffs at the bottom, Champion all over print. These are really nice. They're reverse weave, so they're nice material. Shout out to the subscriber that hooked these up. I bought these off of a marketplace online, and basically I hit up the dude asking for like 20 or 30 shipped. I can't remember what it was. I honestly was planning on selling them originally, but the dude recognized me. He said he watches my videos, and he hit me up and was like, bro, like, I will give it to you for $10. Crazy steal. I think these retail at like 60 or 70 bucks from Urban Outfitters, so big shout out to him, bro. I have to keep these now. Like, I was gonna sell them, but I want to rock them a lot now just because a subscriber hooked it up, so I really do appreciate that. He sent me this box logo with a little note on it, and I'll read it real quick for you guys. Hey Boone, sorry for the delay on shipping. Just got caught up with the 3-day weekend. No worries, homie. Hope you enjoy the pants. Thanks for being such an inspiration and keep making amazing content. Thanks again. FYI, you helped me manual cop my Rust box logo. Big shout out to you, my G. Like, that's so dope that I was able to help you cop something from Supreme. If you guys don't know, I have a really informative video on how to buy stuff from Supreme. Believe it or not, even though I know I do take several L's, I do actually have very good tips. And I'm going to be trying my best to cop from Supreme North Face this week. I'm gonna be trying my hardest. Like, I'm not gonna be going for the most hype size and color like I have been. We'll get more into my strategy though, maybe later on in this video. The other item I have to show off is this yellow Tommy Jeans t-shirt. So fire. If you guys didn't know, I did just pick up the other colorway of this shirt, the nice red and blue. Let me know what you guys prefer. I do think the red and blue is my favorite, but this bumblebee colorway is going crazy. Unfortunately, it cannot transform. I wish it could transform into maybe like a box logo, who knows. Very fire pickups though for the website. I don't want to make this intro too long, so let's just jump into talking about this week now. I will try to give little like resale estimates because people are always asking me about resale and I feel like I don't cover it enough, so my apologies. Starting it off, we have what I'm most excited for with this week. These red box logo Zippos. Oh my lord, these are so fire. Even though they're not even that crazy or like well thought out, just a box logo slapped on a Zippo. Still looks crazy sick in my opinion. I love it so much. I was not able to cop week one. I cooked up so much stuff week one, like over 10 items, I believe. Unfortunately, this was not one of them. I honestly thought I grabbed it, but I was putting so much stuff in my cart, I didn't even realize I missed it. This is definitely one of my favorite Zippos they've ever released from Supreme. They've done a lot of really sick Zippos. I'm holding in my hand right now one that I got from like 2 seasons ago, I believe. This is the iridescent Zippo, and I honestly think it's a super sick Zippo. I love the colors on it. I definitely think this one's hard. However, you cannot beat the big old red box logo. I love my glaring loud box logo, so I have to grab one of these because I did not get them week one. If you guys did in fact buy one of these week one, unfortunately you cannot cop it again. You can only buy one of each item from Supreme. I know when the shoulder bag restocked, I was going crazy because I could not get one, just because I'd already bought one from Supreme. Let's move in now though to these crazy like little pouches. I don't even know what these are, bro, to be honest. Watertight roll down pouch with belt loop and adjustable neck cord. So I'm a little confused exactly what these are. There's some kind of pouches. I don't know if they're like floatable. It looks like they might be some like inflatable pouches. I'm not quite positive. You already know your boy has to cop it just because it has a big old Supreme box logo on it. I don't even know what it is, and I'm still gonna cop it just because it's a Supreme accessory that's got loud branding. I'm so just like cringy for that. I'm like a complex kid out here, but I'm proud of it. I do like to collect the accessories from Supreme a lot, so I have to grab this. And I do see there's also a black colorway, so you already know your boy's gonna double down on these. I think I'm gonna be grabbing them when I also get this box logo zipper, so catch that in the live cop tomorrow. Drop a subscription if you guys want to check out that live cop tomorrow. I've been hyping it up so much, I'm gonna take a dub, so I better not fail, I swear to God. Next up, we got these tents, and like I said, I'm not gonna cover the Supreme North Face items too much. These tents are super, super insane. I was telling you guys yesterday I'm gonna get one of them. I'm not sure which color, though. I'm trying to think right now. I might get the red one. The black one, for me, is just, like, a little boring. I do think the black looks better on every clothing piece. However, in this one instance, I like the colored one a bit more, and I mean, that technically is a red bottom, so you already know your boy's about to have his first red bottom Supreme box logo. I'm gonna be living luxurious in this. I'm actually moving out of my crib just to go live in this Supreme tent. Hypebeast lifestyle calls for hypebeast movements. I might be living the streets, but I still will be flexed the hell up. But honestly, I do think I want to get that red colorway. Let me know what color you guys think I should get. I'm gonna be getting the homie to proxy this for me, so I won't be going for it in the live cop, but I really do hope he has success. I might even break it open and just like show it off in a video, because these are insane. These are a really dope accessory. Next, we have this pouch already. We talked about that. Let's talk about these basketball jerseys. Supreme, for whatever reason, when it comes to jerseys, I feel like they do a great job with them. It seems like a lot of the Supreme jerseys, like even the soccer jersey with Playboy we saw this year, the basketball jerseys from last season had like nice Sonics colorway. That was crazy hard. I just love a lot of the jerseys they do. I think this one's super sick. It reminds me a lot of some kind of like action figure or maybe like a superhero kind of design. It looks like the Flash combined with the Superman logo. On the side, you have this super sick lightning bolt graphic. I already know all my Ian Connor Revenge Storm fans about to be skirting up on this piece, grabbing this just for that lightning bolt to match the cute little lightning bolt on their fake look-alike Vans. I swear to God, if you guys thought you were the first to think of this idea to match this with the Ian Connor Revenge Storms, you're way behind. You already know your boy's on that 4,000 IQ when it comes to the IG Insta clout photos. Follow me on Boone if you guys want to see my Instagram clout photos. I got some crazy ones coming up, I can promise you on that. These are super lit though. I don't have any Ian Connor Revenge Storms to wear these with, so I can't cop, unfortunately. If you're looking to resell, I'd definitely go for the black or the white colorway. I don't think these other two colors are nice at all, to be honest. Again, I don't want to talk about these too much. The more I look at them though, I do think this one's actually nicer than this one. I think the green is just like a little more colorful, but bro, why aren't there more colors for this collab? Like, come on. Such shitty colorways for this collab. Like, it's so disappointing to think about what could have been. Again, just disappointing. Just, oh man, bro. The more I look at the Supreme North Face drop, the more disappointed I get. Let's move into these basketball shorts, though. These are way better than the jerseys, in my opinion, in terms of resale, just because I think they're more wearable. Not everyone wants to rock a basketball jersey, but everyone can wear shorts, especially when it's summertime. I do think the red looks a lot nicer when it comes to the shorts, but again, black and white, black definitely is the best. Red might be second best, white's probably third. I'm not a huge fan, I wouldn't cop them personally. I do like, though, that they remind me so much of comic book type stuff. Like, we even have little 3D drop shadows on the lightning bolts. That's super sick. Let's move on to this chest stripe terry top. I hate this, so boring. Supreme just didn't even try at all with this design. They could have used like a different color in the middle besides white on all these, because it looks terrible, at least in my opinion. Again, I wish they'd use a different color on this little logo, the script logo. I do love that spell out. However, I think this is just a very boring piece. I don't think Supreme was trying at all with the design on it. Let's go to these overdyed crew neck sweatshirts. In my opinion, again, these are rather boring. I don't think they're ugly. I actually really like overdyed looks, just because overdyed kind of looks like a vintage fade. It's a very faded look. So if you guys don't like that look, I would not cop these. However, I do prefer that because I like vintage. None of these colorways stand out that much in my opinion. I definitely am not going to cop these, and I would not buy them if you're trying to resell. I'm really curious what like a peach overdyed would look like, but yeah, I'm not going to be getting any of these. I don't like the colors that much. Next, let's go to the hardware top. And this one honestly is so sick to me. Like, I don't understand why people are hating on this, because I think it's actually a super interesting t-shirt. Supreme's never done a shirt that looks like this. I mean, they've done a lot of all over stuff, but nothing that looks like this. It's basically like a store, a storefront, as you can obviously see. Supreme Hardware. First off, I love this subtle Supreme branding. You couldn't even tell it's like a Supreme shirt unless you actually knew. And then on the back, the little liquor store touch. Of course, Supreme has to add in that edgy sauce one time, and they did with the liquor store in the back. But I love this t-shirt, bro. I think this is so sick. Like, I don't know, you guys might disagree with me, but I just like the look of it. It almost looks like a painting, even though I do believe it is a photo. These are going for $110 though, so I understand sleep in. If this was like $60, I might cop it, but definitely too much money for me. I'm not blowing that much on this t-shirt. However, I do like it a lot, and I think it's a super dope design. Next, we got the Drugs Rayon shirt, and again, a little bit of sauce of the edginess with the Drugs spell out here on the top, but I think it's funny. I think the shirt is just super sick looking again. Very similar to the other shirt where it looks like it's like a real photo, but it also looks like a painting at the same time. It also has these labels all over the sides. I think this will age very well in terms of its resale value. Along with this, I think both of them will have resale value down the road as time goes on. Maybe right away, who knows? I think they're super dope. I almost want to grab one of these, but I don't think I will. I'm really curious what you guys have to say about them, so comment if you like those shirts or not. Next, you got the Contrast Stitch work jacket. Definitely don't like these that much, to be honest. I think they could have been way sicker if they didn't have contrast stitching all over them. It just looks bad to me. Like, it's just too out there. It's too eye-catching. I do like the colorways. That plum's gorgeous. I think it's a green or a black. I can't tell. I'm colorblind. Not really, though. This blue one's sick. Definitely nothing I would cop, though. These collar shirts are absolutely atrocious. I hate these. They're so boring. Like, there's just nothing to them that you can even talk about. We got the mesh side panel camp caps. Not that interesting again. Definitely very breathable though for your head. If you guys got some sweaty ass tops, I would definitely recommend these. I don't rock camp caps, so you already know I'm missing these. However, the olive I think looks really nice, but I don't think I'll be copping. I think it's interesting the ventilation on some of them is different colors from the actual like hat itself, while others are all tonal. I don't know which I prefer, but let's take a look now at these friend six panels. These are very, very weird. It looks like some like amusement park type shit. I don't know. They're very out there. I respect Supreme for trying to do something different with the hat department, just trying to do some different design. I do think I'd actually really like this design on a t-shirt. Hopefully you guys can get a good like little preview of what it looks like, but I actually think it's like a cool fun little print. Reminds me a lot of the Blade collab from a while ago, like 3 or 4 seasons ago. I don't think I'll cop. I definitely know I won't cop, but I mean, they're not that bad. I don't know, maybe they are to you guys, who knows. I definitely think I'm gonna be going for this colorway of the jacket tomorrow, this green yellow color, probably in a size medium or large. I think XL and small sell out first. Let me know what you guys are gonna go for tomorrow with Supreme North Face. Let me know what you guys just think of this week in general. Definitely not the best Supreme week. Not as bad as a lot of people are saying, especially on YouTube. I see a lot of people hating on this week, but I don't think it's that terrible, but maybe I'm just like trying to stick up for Supreme too much. I don't know.